Hi, my name is Lily Thomas, and I've been coming to Sailorville since 2011. I'm Guyanese. I was born in Guyana, South America. My mom's Guyanese, and my dad is Zimbabwean. My childhood was a bit traumatic. Growing up, my dad struggled a lot with alcoholism, and he was physically abusive towards my mom. So basically, a typical day for me, since as far as I can remember, is just going to school or preschool or whatever, and coming home and just being scared and just in fear because, you know, like that night, what's gonna happen? He's gonna come home drunk and he's just gonna beat up your mom and take you through this whole process over and over again. So that was basically my life. And my mom told me I couldn't tell anyone, or like no one could know. So it's just a lot of stuff that I had to keep inside. I think that really started to unravel when I got to high school. All the stuff that I'd been keeping inside, I started to deal with in all the wrong ways. High school started off pretty well. Like, I was fine, like, the first year, like, good grades and everything. And then I started off first with an eating disorder. I started starving myself and started throwing up anything I did eat. That I struggled with for all of my teenage years. I also struggled with smoking. I started to smoke cigarettes, I started to drink a lot, I started to smoke a lot of pot, I started hanging out with the wrong people. When I was 17, I was at a friend's party, and I remember being really, really low, and just, I was really drunk as well, and I remember thinking that I just wanted it all to end, that I was just tired of feeling so low and so like nothing, like my life had no purpose, that I was just a waste of space, and that that this was all I had to my life, and I was just done. I remember, thankfully, I say thankfully because I was so drunk that I took the wrong set of pills from my friend's dad's closet, and I didn't take enough of those to do any damage, and it just made me pass out basically because of the combination of the alcohol. Like, I guess growing up, I thought my dad didn't really care about me because he drank, you know, he did all that stuff, but you realize in that moment that they do care, and I just really scared them. But at the same time, I still didn't know how to communicate all the hurt and, like, pain I was feeling. I didn't know how to talk about that or deal with that yet. Something was missing, something very big was missing, and I didn't know how to... I didn't know what it was. During this time, my dad was sick. He had a lot of heart problems. December 30th, 2008, he passed away. We took him to the hospital. And I remember before we took him out of the car to get him in, he was just sitting in the back seat just staring at me. And that memory is just forever like burnt into my brain because it's one of the last memories I have of him alive, him just staring at me, and like now I look back and think, like, what was he thinking? You know, was he thinking of all those moments that he caused us harm, and that was he looking for forgiveness? Was he just trying to tell me that he loved me? And I didn't say anything. I just still acted like I didn't care, and just they took him into the hospital, and as they were taking him in, he collapsed, and that's when he died. I met Josh Thomas on September 2009. He was in the Marine Corps, and he was stationed at the American Embassy in Zimbabwe there, and we were set up on a blind date. Josh had gone SAVE at a younger age, but after being in the Marines, he kind of been making some bad decisions. We met at a club, and after that, we hit it off. About a month or two after we started hanging out, and we were dating, which he knew was wrong because I wasn't a believer, but we did it anyway. A month after, he sat me down and shared the gospel with me. I'd heard the gospel before, but I'd never taken heed of it. But the one thing he said to me that made me want to learn more, made me really take it seriously this time, was he said that, "I don't know what's going to happen to you or to us after I leave Zimbabwe, but I want to know that I'm going to see you in heaven one day." And for some reason that really resonated and really stuck to me, and I thought, okay, well, I want to learn more, I want to know more. He talked to his parents, and I think he got the Chuck DeClean's John study for me to do. And we went through that for about 6 months. And there was just, I didn't feel anything. Like, I remember just going through it and like, I know, but I just didn't feel anything. I think I still had so much anger towards God. I was holding on to this "you didn't save my dad" mentality. And Josh had to go to Trinidad and Tobago for his next post. And we were apart for a month. And it's really cool because I think like God uses those moments when you're so low and so down, you know, to really just make your heart tender and to bring you closer to him. And I was really low, and because I missed Josh, and it was the first time apart, and I just remember being in my room, and it was like just a veil had been lifted, and everything made sense. Like all the stuff Josh had been saying, everything made sense. Like I was like, I am a sinner. Like, I need God in my life. Like I'm hopeless. Like I'm completely dead in my sin. And I realized that God sent his son Jesus to die for us, to die for my sins. All that stuff, all the weed and partying and dating and boys and all that stuff, like that I tried to heal myself and fill that hole with, that's not what I needed. What I needed was God. I needed Jesus. I needed a savior. And when I realized that, I was just brought down to my knees, and I just remember crying and asking God to forgive me and to come into my life, and that I needed him so badly, and that I couldn't do this on my own. I remember thinking like that I was just so dark, that I had just such a dark hole in me, and that I just wasted so much time doing all the wrong things. I guess looking back now, I think of how I just cursed God and how I turned my back on him and just hated him, and knowing that with every step of the way he was with me, and he never deserted me. He never thought, oh, she's hopeless, or she cursed me, or she doesn't want me and I'm done with her. He just kept coming after me.